to another boring topic on computer organization and hacking. So today we're going to talk about instruction cycle. So what is instruction cycle? Instruction cycle is a process by which a computer retrieves a program instruction from its memory, determines what action the instruction dictates, and carries out those actions. The two major components that works together in the cycle is the CPU and the RAM. So here's the list of the components that are in the CPU and RAM. Oh, and not forgetting those pesky I/O modules and system bus, which are everywhere. So there are literally only two steps in this cycle. One is fetch, the other is execute. So in the main memory are the instructions that are stored. This is an example of an instruction. The instruction consists of an operation code and a memory address. Now, to put that little brain into use, we should memorize the common operation codes, such as 1, 2, 5, and also remember what does each number mean. Moving on to the most important part of this topic is the diagram and how to actually utilize it. So here's an example of a diagram. We will start off with the fetch cycle. These are the memory cells located in the RAM, and they contain the instructions and their addresses. And located in the CPU registers are the program counter, accumulator, and the instruction register. So according to the program counter, the address given is 300. So we have to find that particular address in the RAM and place that instruction in the address into the instruction register while waiting for the next step, which is the execute cycle. In this cycle, the CPU will read the instruction in the instruction register. If we recall back, there are two parts of the instruction, one the operation code and the other the address. So in this specific cycle, the operation is to move the data from memory to the accumulator. So it is just simply copying the data from the memory into the accumulator. And voila, we're done. Piece of cake, right? Well, here are some other examples of different operations just to widen your view. At least try to make an effort to understand these diagrams.